everybody, Liz Kohler here from Surgent CPA Review. One of the areas I get lots of questions on involves ratios. So I thought I'd spend some time with you today to give you some quick tips on how to memorize some key ratios. The first ratio I want to recommend you get familiar with is the return on ratio. So let's say return on equity or return on assets. Simple way to remember it. The phrase return on means net income divided by. So if you have return on equity, the way to calculate it is net income divided by equity. Return on assets, net income divided by assets. Piece of cake. Second set of ratios, the turnover ratios. So what's a turnover? It's sales divided by what you're turning over. Now, sometimes we have to qualify that sales. So for example, a receivable turnover would be net credit sales, not all sales. Makes sense, right? So net credit sales divided by, usually they take an average of the receivables. So net credit sales divided by average net receivables. Pretty easy. How about an inventory turnover? Well, that would be cost of goods sold divided by average inventory. Another set of ratios are ratios that involve the word to. So debt to equity. When you see the word to between two words, it means divide by. So debt to equity would be debt divided by equity. Debt to assets would be debt divided by assets. There you go. You can have a whole slew of ratios solved there pretty quickly. Another set of ratios involve the word margin. So if you see margin, it usually means divide by sales. So a profit margin would be gross profit divided by sales. An operating margin would be operating profit divided by sales. Now, there are two that they like you to know the formulas that I think are pretty complicated. And so I'll mention them briefly. And I do think it's important that you really vet them. The first one is earnings per share. And that formula, just got to commit it to memory. Net income minus the preferred dividend, the current preferred dividend, divided by the weighted average of the common shares outstanding. Now, you may get questions on the BEC portion of the exam. You could also see questions on the FAR section. You could even get it on audit. You never know. So I really recommend you memorize that formula. And of course, the last one is times interest earned, TIE. And that's earnings before interest and taxes. So EBIT divided by interest payments. Simple way to remember it. Earnings before interest and taxes divided by interest. Those are the key ratios that I think every candidate should have in their repertoire. And if you've got those key ratios down, it's going to help you pass the CPA exam. Hey, thanks for joining me today. If you have any more questions, please visit us at surgentcpareview.com. I look forward to helping you pass the CPA exam.